imagine yesterday was like a sad day in Nigeria. Nobody celebrated democracy like Abuja. Nobody cared anymore. But I'm very cynical about the university. They thought the last few years would be very different. This is why it didn't happen. So I'm sure that the president himself will have been shocked by the day of silence and very critical analysis of the institution. Nothing to write about.
Okay, well, maybe we should start from the beginning. He talked about security and said, they're going to fight security, headlong. He's not going to allow that. And we need to support.
Yeah.
What do you think he has done so far when you look at the adaptive
girls? They'll fight Boko Haram in the first room of coming to power. The president did not appoint ministers for 6 months. And that point, Nigeria to recession and later on into depression. Right now, Nigeria is probably a master to the world and will grow its economy by 1.9%.
Yes. This is
I don't know how to describe it, but you know what? We've done the worst in the last few years, and it is time for us to start thinking about how to finally retire them out of office. And that will be next year.
Well, you also said that the inflation rate is declined.
Where did you get the figures from?
Yes, Buhari. It said the inflation rate is declined.
Well, you can, like I said to you earlier, you can say anything you want to say, but at the end of the day, the best results can be gotten from the streets, from the markets. When you go to the market, you ask people, have you gotten the price of things come down? I mean, when they came on board, the price for rubber bag of rice was about 7,000 naira.
Four, five, six?
Yeah, within that first 1 year of that inflation, went all the way to 24,000 naira. Now it's about 14,000 naira. It's going to celebrate. What are we celebrating, really, in the United States? So for me, the best results can be gotten from the street. Like I say, you cannot expect people to celebrate efforts. People want to celebrate. And if that results are not being perceived by the people, then there's nothing to be excited about.
Okay, let me address it. You also talked about the whistleblowing that has made us generate 5 billion naira from that.
So, 5 billion?
Yes, 5 billion from that.
Fortunately, where is the money being kept? Who did they get the money from? You don't just whistleblow on someone and you don't know who the money came from. But even when you pay back in the road case, you don't return to the name of the they wanted to release the names of all the voters. The only thing they did was to release the names of people who had several events with them. So, listen, we're going to a point where Nigerians will start taking critical level in the next steps on how fast we can get them out. There have been a strong level of progress in the last 3 years. Everybody's come to that final argument. They talked about security, but Boko Haram has become even more important. They should by now have an embassy for diplomatic representative for Abuja so that they can pick up their checks on a regular basis. Pay them 5 million euros in the last 3 years. They have even become so bold that they can not pick 104 girls, drive them back after the negotiation, and even address the village as they want them to send them to children to school. X-Men are all over the place on rampage. There's nothing that was there.
Are you saying they've done nothing? Is that what you're saying? Are you saying there's nothing this administration has done?
You know, I'm not just signing to stay in front of you, I'm a media person too. So it's my job until a few weeks ago to actually report on achievement or non achievement of government officials in this country. And the results that they're doing investigative reports on the time to reveal how the dishonest about corruption or the claim of corruption or the fighting corruption. All the poor people who are members of their party are having a good day. The ones that are not party members are the ones that are counting on the party. That is not the kind of country we want. When you have someone like Obadi Koro who was elected to Kitike, he's back on behalf of the APC as a main operational person to help them with the election of the Kitike coming up very soon. That tells you the hypocrisy, the dishonesty, and the strengthened nature of their achievement that you can't. Even if you put yourself, you know, you can't find it. They
okay, hold on a bit. I'm going to get back to you. There's a caller. Hello, good morning to you.
Good morning.
Good morning. Can you see this saying I'm going to get yes, good morning to you. Go ahead. Go ahead.
Good morning, Valerie.
This
is the first time discussing the mirror. We are praying that the best of God, Nigeria is a good country. And then as we discuss positively about Nigeria, let us also know for sure that the only God can lead us. And we need the youth of the world. Let us retire all these old men from our politics. And I'm sure that Nigeria will be great again.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Can the youth take over?
This is for the young people to take. This election is a walk, it's going to be a walkover. If two things happen, if youth can shake off their complacency.
I remember that year when we contested the last elections, loads of people decided that they were tired of the previous administration and they voted in this government. What made them just lose hope so soon? It's just 3 years.
Again, you know, if there's no progress, you will find a correct evidence of progress. And like I said, it started failing from day one.
Why did you say that? I'm going to hold you on there again. I'll allow you. Hello, good morning to you.
Good morning to you. This is Andy Green from Asia.
Okay.
Gentlemen, my greetings to all of you. I want to say one thing in this country. We are living in our country, Nigeria. I want you to go on with this. Buhari is not a man. But we are the people to watch out. He came with good intentions, but our cabal turned into be what he is today. I want to understand one thing. Boko Haram is not the issue, it's political. What is happening today is the way you lay your destiny is life. When the first administration was in power, that speech was not good. violence speech today, cause people come out to speak the truth. Let him face so-called henchmen that is under the nation are going to face in this country.
Thank you, sir.
Why is it that, since all these days, they don't prosecute people who stole money? When election leader come up, they come with that. They don't have a solution for this country.
Okay, we can take more of those things. Thank you so much. Yes, you had it.
You know, I'm tired of people saying that I had good intentions and some cabals. You cannot have good intention on one side, and you are responsible for implementing your intention. And then you assemble another set of people. We talk about, and they are derailing the intention. You don't do anything about it. You are the bad person. If your intentions are derailed by the bad people who you elected or you brought into office or you brought with you to power, they are his baggage. He's the one who brought them. I would want to believe that Buhari may have not had the capacity to run Nigeria. And he showed it very early. He even said it in South Africa that if he was younger, maybe he would have performed. But I doubt that even if you gave him this position when he was 20, he'd be able to.
Why did you say he wouldn't have performed if he had this position a few years back before now?
Because it's very clear that he didn't do anything to show that he even had any antecedent that showed that he's capable of resolving the kind of problems that he was confronted with. And that's why you hear people repeating the same thing on TV all the time about, oh, you have good intentions. What's the meaning of that? How does that translate to, you know, ending hunger? How does that translate to bringing us electricity, jobs, you know, improving the health sector? The man doesn't even believe in our doctors. When he's sick, he flies to London. You know, when they found people who were corrupt in government, he refuses to fire them. When they know that the chief of army staff was buying houses in Dubai, they kept them, they hid them, they covered all those things up. Buhari is a person who is very cunning.
You mean President Buhari?
Yes, President Buhari. Not this time, you know, Buhari. And I'm sure this must be haunting you a lot. I'm so sorry about that. But, you know, he's a cunning man. That's what I have
your seen. Thoughts?
Yes, that's what I've known about him. You know, I have covered most presidents, and I know characteristically when I see a very cunning person.
Okay, that's your thought anyway. But he said something when he started his speech that this democracy is nascent. What's your word for
well,
it?
How can
are we not 19 years?
No, you don't have democracy that started a few years ago that I've been better. There's nothing necessary about democracy. The problem with our democracy is that we have not had a chance, or we have refused, uprightly, and we should blame ourselves for it. We have refused to elect competent people to lead us. We keep making the same mistakes. And that's where we have come, and young people like us have said, you have a chance, this is final chance, to move in a different direction. Do not put back into power another incompetent mediocre to run Nigeria, because Nigeria is not going to make any progress, and we just have a bed to turn in. And that is that right now we are living the internet era, we are living the digital era, we are going into artificial intelligence, and people who are not even street smart or street wise cannot lead Nigeria. Like I usually describe, the present crop of leaders are like Nokia 3300. And Nigeria needs to be moving at the pace of iPhone X.
But we seem to be missing this point. It wasn't President Buhari that started this administration. I'm talking about democracy. It started a long time ago, 19 years ago. Why are we putting all the book on him?
Well, yes. you can shy away from putting the book on him because obviously he's the president currently. But see, fundamentally, it's okay for people to think he's honest. It's okay for people to think that he's got bad adjutants and whatever. But like I said earlier, if you do not have the capacity to fire, do not hire. And this is one of the problems that the administration is facing. I expected a shock when I'm coming. It's all right for you to start on the wrong foot. But you know, the people want to see you start, you know, making the right relevant changes that will give us the kind of result that we want to see. But when we do not see that, we get really concerned, we get really worried. And right now, my people say Friday will be good, you start getting a vibe from Tuesday, Wednesday. We don't see it happening. So the same thing we said about the previous administration under Goodluck Jonathan, who was a fantastic guy, he's a good guy, he has the people at heart. But we saw incompetence, we saw the inability to actually drive the system. So what we are seeing right now is, look, it doesn't matter if you're good or not good. If you cannot give us results, it's nothing for us to celebrate. We cannot keep celebrating efforts. We don't want to celebrate our results. So for me, it doesn't matter who is in charge or who isn't in charge, it's just about what the people on the streets are feeling. So you talk about inflation, and I'm telling people are still hungry. You talked about the improvement in the economy, I'm telling people are still losing jobs. So what are we talking about? How are we moving forward?
Okay, maybe I should read this yesterday part of the speech. It said, homegrown school feeding program. It said about 8.2 million pupils are currently being fed from 24 states of the Federation, with over 75,000 catering staff engaged under that program.
Again, we cannot defend things like this. When we talk about data, so if we don't have proper data management systems, you can't seem to run this country. It's the same problem we're talking about here. So now you're saying you want to take up on a feeding program, and you can't even tell us how many people you're going to feed just next year, because you can't tell us how many people are going to be in school.
But they've told us the people they fed already, about 8.2 million.
But they are not verifiable results for this.
Figures.
They're just figures. We can't verify this. In Lagos, a lot of kids still going to schools that we can't even tell us feeding them.
Beyond that, what is their own budget compared to the budget that was so wrong for feeding compared to the school feeding budget? And secondly, you see so many of these kids, they clean their feeding. They don't even have tables upon which to put their
plates.
They sit on the floor. So their priorities are wrong, and it is because of incompetence. I am not sure that President Buhari knows what is going on in this country. I'm not sure. I just think they're just shoving him around, you know, and hoping that they'll use him to gain power. And when they gain power again, they'll just package him and take him to London to go and arrest for a long time. There is a group of people who are using him, and I'm sure he's also the laws being used. And they are all part and parcel of the people dragging down the progress of this country. That is bottom line here.
What would you have done differently? Because we must wrap up now. What would you have done differently?
If I would have been in power in the last 10 years, by now there would be 45,000 megawatts of electricity,
how
solar energy alone from the northern part of the country. I would have finished the Lagos Ibadan Expressway in less than 3 months. By now we would have finished the one from Ibadan. We would have done Kano, Kaduna, and would have had a train by now almost reaching Calabar. I mean, in other states, we will not be clearing ground on even the rail line that they promised. The salary the promised workers have been negotiating for 3 years. They are now saying that it's not possible to do it again until September. This is not the government. Don't let us keep deceiving ourselves. Here is it, let's just forget about that. We have a chance in a few months. And I've presented myself to you people that I can do better than this guy in my sleep. I will repeat it again. If I'm sleeping, I can run this country better than the present proposal.
What would you have done differently?
So for me, I want us to reduce the kind of promises we make to Nigeria, because there's a whole lot of mess going on in the system. What we're appealing to Nigeria is to start looking for differently. Like he mentioned correctly, we need to start taking another bench. And we will have to understand that if Nigerians want the kind of democracy that they deserve, they should be prepared to pay for it. Preparing to pay for it has to mean you have to participate. Preparing to pay for it has to mean that you have to come up with ideas. You have to support people that are trying to run. You have to listen to the ideas that they have and see if they're going to be actualizable, realizable, and smart. For me, right now, the country is on a downward spiral, and I expect that we get more young people running for offices, because just running for the office of the president is not sufficient enough. We need about 505 people running the National Assembly. We need about 500, another number of people running for state governors, another number of people running for the Senate and House of Reps. These are the kind of people that can work with us and see how we can achieve all of the plans that we can have.
And I want to say with respect to Buhari that my position on things I can do, the promises I mean, they come with guarantee, warranty, and insurance. And that's my character. Okay. I've been around doing this for 29 years.
Okay, finally, let's hear what advice you offer for the people, the electorate.
Electorates, you have to obtain your PVC. In it has your next bridge, your next school, hospital. You have to ensure that you vote and you protect your votes. And you have to make sure that you vote for people who are capable. You vote for Modi Eletu, whereas the next president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, so that by next year, you can at least be sure that you have a president who will do what he has said he will do. And who is better to do it is the guy who's been in for 29 years. Starting from the University of Lagos here, we'll take it and make sure that every corner of this country is going to be a fresh place of life in a few months from now.
Your words for the electorate.
It's okay to talk about it today, even though I won't pay for it.
I don't say your words for the electorate.
Oh, yes. It's fine. I'll say vote for me, vote for Ahmed Buhari. The reason why we're pushing this is because I'm the first person that started this whole push for young people to emerge, even though people actually say that age is not a function of good leadership, but what we do believe can give us the kind of country that we deserve.
expect a difference. So thank you.
We want to thank you for coming, Oshere, and also Ahmed Bogari. Thank you so much for coming.
My pleasure.
I wish you well.
Thank
I wish you the best. Well, the other tone up next is Superdome Sports. And the